Philippine Stock Exchange Index drops to its lowest level since early 2014. Shares around the region face another bout of volatile trading. But are we already headed into bear market territory? We have now on the line Jonas Ravelas, Chief Market Strategist at BDO, to help us make sense of all these. So is it bear market or not? Jonas, tell us where we are.
Well, basically, since the market opened, we actually entered bear market when we fell below 6,500. Bear market is defined as 20% from the top. So coming from 8,136 in early part of 2015. So we're actually here.
We're here on the reasons that we're very worried about what's going on in China. We've got geopolitical risk. How worried should investors be, and how risk averse should they be at this point?
Oh, well, basically, I guess because of the series of unfortunate events, this risk aversion period, which I mentioned last week in your show, it takes at least 6 weeks, or just on the second week, as the market digests these events, the China slowdown, the sell-off in the equity markets, currency depreciation, you have geopolitical risk out of Saudi Arabia. So investors are eventually rebalancing their portfolios to suit this present uncertainty.
So there's four to six weeks to go before we hit bottom. Are you changing your index forecast in the PSE? Because you had one of the lowest when we talked to you last week at around 6,000.
Well, I think that 6,000 will remain. I think despite the other forecasts that are probably the next technical resistance after 6,000 is around 5,700, I think the 6,000 level could hold.
And you mentioned about rebalancing portfolio. That's what you're advising investors. Exactly how should one go about it if you're retail investors and wanting to avoid risk at this point and cut losses?
Oh, well, basically, for retail investors, I think the key here is to look for index issues that will continue to grow in our environment, mainly because we are a consumer-driven economy, so this will most likely be food, retail, real estate. So these counters, particularly that the index now is down by close to 3% or lower, we will find value in certain in these index-linked issues at this time. So if the market moves to 6,000, then definitely from a value perspective, this is what I call cheap. And if we were to compare the Philippines against other counters in the region, you'll understand that in 2015, the issues of overvaluation was there. But if the physics were to move towards 6,000 to where it is now, it is between 14 to 14 and a half times 2016 earnings. So that would more or less be at par with other ASEAN counters like Indonesia, Malaysia.
Okay.
Stock market.
All right, Jonas, thank you so much for that clarity.